Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Have you ever found one of these? It's called a brain block. Legend says that if you hold it over your head on a full moon, you'll become 100 times smarter than you already are. And I totally didn't find this behind a convenience store. Darn it. I guess tonight's not the night. But it looks like you don't always need a brain block to become smarter. You humans seem to have already done that and increased your brain size through evolution. It might actually account for a lot of the ways that you are today. With regards to evolution, it's commonly thought that humans and other primates descended from a common ancestor, though nobody really knows for sure who that was. My guess is that it was Fred over there. That guy's always starting something, you know, he looks really suspicious. I think it might have to do with the fact that he has a face. But what would it be like if you all of a sudden de-evolved? We don't really know for sure, but we can make a good guess. Beyond you likely not being as intelligent, without evolution, it's possible that you'd be walking around on all fours. It's actually pretty unique that humans typically stand up and walk around on two legs, which is known as bipedalism. While many other primates are capable of bipedalism, you'll see them moving around on all fours, known as quadrupedalism, a lot more than you will a human. There are a bunch of different theories on just how you came to be the bipedal animal that you are. But no matter how you got there, it seems like walking around on two legs has some advantages and disadvantages compared to your four-footed friends. One study found, compared to quadrupedal mammals with the same body mass, human walking is pretty economical in terms of expending metabolic energy, while a person running around is pretty expensive. See, I'm not lazy, I'm just economical. Without evolution, you might also have fur all over your body. It's heavily debated as to why humans don't have fur anymore, but one of the more fun ideas suggests that millions of years ago, your ancestors evolved to lose their fur because of their semi-aquatic lifestyle. It's not a phase, Mom. This is who I really am. However, there's a severe lack of evidence for there ever being an aquatic phase in human existence, so this idea doesn't get a lot of credibility. It seems like a more appropriate idea is that humans lost their fur to help with temperature regulation. But what if instead of not evolving, we instead evolved to be more like other primates? In that case, you might be more inclined to go on a vegan diet, or at least one with more fruits and veggies. That's because many primates don't have meat-heavy diets. A 2013 study that compiled 219 primate dietary studies over 42 years of research across 17 countries found that medium and larger-sized primates had more plant-based diets focused on fruits and foliage. That being said, chimpanzees, some of your closest relatives among the apes, are actually pretty omnivorous and will kill and eat other animals. They've even been seen sucking brains from the heads of monkeys. No, don't show it. Don't, animator, don't, you don't have to show it.
Oh.
Well, now you saw that. For now, it seems like you humans will keep on changing and evolving into something different than what you are now. What do you think humans will look like in a million years? Let me know in the comments section below. Here's another question for you. Do you think you, as you are now, could survive 2.5 million years ago? Check out this video to find out. This was a much cooler and drier Earth, so already, unless you have an incredibly insulating jacket, your chances of survival are looking pretty slim. As always, my name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.